tribute was paid to Margaret Roberts-Steele by some of the many broadcasters whose careers had been influenced in some way by her. Her work spans decades, which started when she joined the defunct Windward Island Broadcasting Service in 1956. Her voice became synonymous with quality interviews and vivid outside broadcast commentaries. She was often called on to conduct training for young broadcasters and has inspired three generations of broadcasters, especially young women.
One of the most empowering experiences of my early career was to sit shoulder to shoulder with Mrs. Steele, sharing a mic on an outside broadcast. The 1,000 degrees of separation between our experience, our knowledge, and training evaporated, and we became equals, simply Margaret and Barbara, colleagues. She took control of these OBs, but all the while treating me as if I too had been trained at the BBC.
Margaret always took the time to pass on gems of professionalism from her vast knowledge of broadcasting to us. The young on-air staff, we learned the importance of diction, articulation, pronunciation, intonation, voice modulation, voice inflection, how to read at a steady pace, conduct interviews properly, and how to present programs of every musical genre.
A Grenadian by birth, Robert Steele settled in St. Lucia after marrying in 1969. She was awarded a member of the Most Excellent Order of the British Empire in 2019.
If you are thinking of something to live on, to carry on Sister Margaret Steele's legacy, I would encourage anyone of the group of trainers whom she has trained to invite or come in and train some of our young people where we can have some young Margaret Steele.
Margaret Roberts-Steele passed away in her sleep on July 19th, 2022. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.